Now we are going to discuss what is moment of a force. Moment of a force. The moment of a force about a point O. You see that this is our body, and this body is acted upon by a force F. The moment M0, and we are going to find the moment of this force F about the point O. Okay, we are going to find the moment of the force about this point O. So we are denoting it as MO. The moment of the force about the point O is defined as the cross product of the force vector and the distance vector. It is a cross product of the force vector and the distance vector. Now, what is the force vector? The force vector is F. And what is the distance vector? Distance vector is R, isn't it? So, what will be our moment? Our moment is equal to the product of the force vector and the cross product. The cross product of the force vector and the distance vector. Now, what is force vector? Force vector is vector F. What is distance vector? Distance vector is vector R. And now, when we are going to consider the direction, the direction of M0 is determined by the right hand rule. Okay, magnitude of the moment is given by, now we are going to find out the magnitude of this moment. Now what about magnitude of the moment? Magnitude of the moment is actually it is the force into perpendicular distance towards the point. So it is the force into perpendicular distance towards the point. So what I am going to do is that I am going to make an axis which is perpendicular to our distance vector R. Okay, so if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. Okay, this angle is also theta. So what is this angle? This angle is 90 minus theta. This is 90 minus theta. So if I am going to resolve F along this direction, it is going to become F sine theta, because this component along R will become F cos theta, because theta is known. Or this will become F, if this can become F sine theta, this can become F sine theta, or it can become F cos 90 minus theta. F cos 90 minus theta. What is F cos 90 minus theta? It is still F sine theta. So what I am going to do is that I am going to resolve F along this direction, which is the perpendicular direction to the distance vector R. Because what is moment? What is moment? Moment is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Moment is equal to force into perpendicular distance. You have to put this in the box. So moment is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Now this force is inclined towards the perpendicular distance. So what I am going to do is that I am going to make the force perpendicular. So I am going to make the force perpendicular to vector R. And when I am going to resolve the force F along the perpendicular direction, it becomes F sine theta. So what is M0? M0 is R into F sine theta. M0 is equal to R into F sine theta, where R is the perpendicular distance and F sine theta is the result component of force F through along the perpendicular direction of R. Now, let a system of forces, now we are going to find out what is called a resultant moment, okay? Let a system of forces act upon a rigid body, okay? Resultant moment of the force about a point is determined by the vector addition of the moments, okay? Now, we know that what is M0? What is M0? M0 is equal to R into F sine theta. Or if you are going to move in the vector format, what is M0? M0 is equal to vector R cross F, vector F, isn't it? So it is vector R cross vector F. Now if it is vector R cross vector F, and there are many number of vector R's and F's, there are many forces, because there is a system of forces acting upon a rigid body. And if system of forces are acting, means F1, F2, F3, F4 are acting, and then there are various distances which are perpendicular distances, R1, R2, R3, R4, or the distance vectors R1, R2, R3, R4, then each will be R1 cross F1, R2 cross F2, then it will be the algebraic sum. It will be the algebraic sum. So this is the resultant moment MR. What is the resultant moment? Resultant moment is algebraic sum of vector R cross vector F. Because vector F is the synonym of the force, and vector R is the synonym of the distance, okay, of the force towards the point under consideration. So this is resultant moment, which is an algebraic sum of all the moments taken into one single resultant moment. Now we will go with the Varignon's theorem. Okay. According to Varignon's theorem, algebraic sum of moments of several concurrent forces about any point is equal to the moment of the resultant about the same point. So that means if you have three forces acting on a system and then your moment is actually F cross R1 plus F2 cross R2 plus F3 cross R3. If this is the resultant moment MR, okay, Varignon's theorem states that the algebraic sum of the moments of several concurrent forces about any point is equal to the moment of the resultant force about the same point. That means that if the resultant force is FR cross R, then this is equal to M into MR. This is equal to MR. So that means you have F1, F2, F3, which are the component forces of FR. You compose F1, F2 and F3 into one single resultant force, and then the algebraic sum of the individual moments of the forces about a point will be equal to the moment of the resultant force about the same point. That is what is Varignon's theorem, and we will demonstrate it with respect to an example. You see, f of x and f of y are component forces of the resultant vector f, because you can write vector f is equal to vector f of x plus vector f of y, because this is parallelogram law. If f of x are two forces are forming two sides of a parallelogram, then your resultant force will be the diagonal of the parallelogram passing through the point of intersection of the two forces f of x and f of y. What is the point of intersection of the two forces? It is A. Okay, so the resultant force is passing through the point of intersection of the two forces f of x and f of y, and that is what is F. Okay, now if the moment of f of x about O is vector f of x dot x, and the moment of f of y about O is actually vector f of y dot y. Okay, so because that is a perpendicular distance, you need not take that this is a vector. It is actually f of x. Magnitude will be f of x into x, and the other magnitude will be f of y into y. F of x perpendicular distance is x, and f of y the perpendicular distance is y. So this is the moment of f of x and f of y about a point A. Now algebraic sum of this component moments about the point A, This is equal to F into what is its perpendicular distance? It is vector F into cross vector R. Okay. And if you are taking only the magnitude, then it will be F dot R. Because F of X and F of Y are the component vectors of vector F. Or you can say F is the resultant vector of F of X and F of Y. So F of X dot X plus F of Y dot Y is equal to F dot R. So you can write either it in the dot format or you can write it in the vector form. Okay. So if you are going with the vector form, then it will be becoming vector F of X vector cross vector X, vector F of Y cross vector Y equals vector F cross vector R. So this is called Varignon's theorem. So what is F of R? F of R is equal to F of X X plus F of Y Y. So algebraic sum of individual moments will be equal to moment of the resultant force about the same point. So what is the individual moment? Individual moment is f of x dot x and f of y dot y, which is equal to f dot r. This is what is called Varignon's theorem. Now, moment of a couple. How can you find the moment of a couple? And before finding the moment of a couple, you must know what is a couple. What is a couple? A couple is two equal and opposite forces separated by a small distance. Okay, I will repeat once again. A couple is two equal and opposite forces separated by a small distance. Here you see, this is vector F. Okay, So this is minus vector F, because you see the force is a vector, and if you assign positive direction to this, and this is minus F. So we take this as plus F and this is minus F, and if they are separated by a distance of vector R, if they are separated by a distance of R, then the system forms a couple. This system is what is called a couple. Okay, so here we have a couple because there is a force plus force F and there is a minus F, and they are separated by a small distance vector R. And what I am going to do is that I am going to find the moment of the couple about a point O. So the couple F plus F and minus F, I am going to find the moment of this couple about the point O. So if I am going to find the moment about this couple O, this is F and the distance vector is R1, and here this is minus F and the distance vector is R2. So what will be the individual moments about O? Individual moments about O will be vector F into vector cross vector R1 plus minus vector F cross R2. So from this we can take F to be common, and then it becomes R1 vector R1 minus vector R2 cross F. And what is vector R1 minus vector R2? Vector R1 minus vector R2 is vector R by triangle law of addition. So instead of vector R1 minus vector R2, you can substitute vector R. So what is the moment? The moment is actually vector R cross F. So what will be the moment of a couple? The moment of a couple will be the cross product of one of the forces constituting a couple and the perpendicular distance separating the couple. Have you understood it? So that means if you have a couple in F, so that means it is plus F and minus F, then what is the moment of the couple? Moment of the couple is single force cross distance between the forces of the couple. So you have to take one single force, which is F, and it is cross R, which is the distance vector separating plus F and minus F. So it is, what is moment of a couple? Moment of a couple is the cross product of magnitude of single force and the vector separating, the distance vector separating the forces of the couple. So this is what is called the moment of a couple.